Please keep in mind that rabbits' tastes are as varied as their personalities. One rabbit may love dandelion greens while another rabbit won't eat them. Kale may not bother one rabbit, but may cause another rabbit to develop gas. You will need to design your rabbit's diet around his or her individual tastes and health issues.
So today we're going to talk about how to add vegetables to your rabbit's diet. It's important to add vegetables and not just give hay and pellets, because vegetables will add variety, water, and fiber. When you add vegetables to your rabbit's diet, it's very important to do it gradually. You start off with one vegetable, you give them a small piece, check if there's any soft stools within the next 24 hours. If not, then you can give them some more. If at any time you see that the rabbit develops soft stools or even diarrhea, then stop feeding them that vegetable. Introducing vegetables to baby bunnies can be done when they're about 3 to 4 months of age, and for them goes the same. Just start feeding it to them very gradually because their digestive system is still very young and very sensitive. For a 6 pound rabbit, you can feed about 1.5 to 2.5 cups per day, and you can separate that, feed it in two separate feedings or feed it to them in one feeding. And the rabbit will probably let you know if they want more or maybe they can do with less if they don't eat everything. So there's a lot of vegetables you can add to your rabbit's diet. And what I like to do is to make a basic batch of vegetables that consists of between 3 and 6 different ones, and then you can add different vegetables as you go. So to start off, you can use romaine lettuce, red leaf lettuce, green leaf lettuce, dandelion greens, green Swiss chard, escarole, mustard greens, collard greens, red Swiss chard. Now don't be alarmed after feeding this to your rabbit if you see discoloration in their urine. That is normal because of the pigments in the vegetable. However, if you do see blood or sludge in your rabbit's urine, it's very important to contact your veterinarian. So another type of vegetable you can feed your bunny is beet tops, carrot tops.
A few more healthy vegetables you can give to your rabbit are fennel, frisée. Celery should be cut into 1-inch pieces. Mosh. Round kale. Sima de rapa, Belgian endive, radish leaves, radicchio.
So there's some vegetables that you can feed to your rabbit, but you have to do it in limited quantities because they can cause gas. And one of them is kale, turnip greens. Don't feed them the turnips. Just take these off and either use them for your own food preparation or just toss them away. Another thing that can cause gas is bok choy, endive, broccoli, as well as cauliflower.
Development of gas. Rabbits may develop gas for any of the following reasons, and or a combination of reasons. They may swallow air while eating. Food may not be chewed properly due to dental problems. The bacteria in the digestive tract is trying to break down non-digestible food. Since rabbits cannot burp or belch, the gas must exit through the digestive tract and be evacuated through the rectum. To say it bluntly, the only way for rabbits to get rid of the painful gas in their stomachs is by farting. Fortunately, gas produced by a rabbit's intestinal bacteria is odorless. Symptoms of gas. Several hours after eating, shows no interest in food or treats, does not want to drink any water. Sitting in a hunched position, eyes are partially closed, head tilted back, grinding his teeth in pain. Lethargic, doesn't want to move. The stomach is making gurgling noises, has runny stool that looks like diarrhea. Stomach area, abdomen, may be slightly distended. Your rabbit may not show all of the above symptoms when suffering from a gas attack. Treatment. Keep the rabbit warm. Fill a plastic bottle like an empty soda bottle with warm water and place it near the rabbit. If the rabbit is cold, he'll snuggle up to the bottle. Warm a towel in the dryer and put it near the rabbit. Again, if the rabbit is cold, he'll move onto the towel. Don't force your rabbit to use the warmed bottle or towel. Give the rabbit some simethicone, like Mylocon infant drops. This is an over-the-counter medication used to relieve gas. Most drugstores will carry this or something similar. Gently massage the rabbit's abdomen. Hold the rabbit on his back in your lap with his tail slightly higher than his head. Starting just under his ribs, gently massage down the abdomen going toward the feet. If it's only gas, the discomfort and pain should end within 12 hours. The rabbit will start eating and drinking on his own. If the symptoms continue longer than 12 hours and/or the rabbit gets worse, take the rabbit to an exotic veterinarian who has a lot of experience with rabbits as soon as possible.
Now, before you feed your rabbit vegetables, it's very important to wash all the vegetables thoroughly. Washing them in your sink and spinning them dry, you can store the vegetables in a container in your fridge, and you can line the bottom of the container with paper towel to absorb any leftover moisture. And rule of thumb is when the vegetables start to go bad, so when your dandelion doesn't look like this anymore, but it starts to look like this and is all weepy, and the same goes for all of the other vegetables, just toss them out, because if it looks not appetizing and you wouldn't eat it, then you don't want to feed it to your rabbit either.
At least one of the daily vegetables should provide vitamin A. Beet greens, carrot tops, and parsley are good choices. For a more complete list and explanation concerning vegetables, see the websites recommended at the end of this video. Vegetables should be fed at room temperature. Take the vegetables out of the refrigerator and allow them to warm up, or soak them in lukewarm water. Serve the vegetables on a clean surface, like a towel, tray, or plate. Never put them directly on the floor where they may be contaminated with fecal material, worm eggs, dirt, etc.
So a well-balanced, nutritious diet for your rabbit contains of unlimited hay, unlimited fresh water, a nice batch of vegetables, and a small amount of pellets on a daily basis. And you can find more about all these topics on the following websites.